says, if I wanted to feel sorry for myself, I'd have stayed with your father.
Ooh, that is quite a drop.
Let me help you down.
I've got this.
What? Oh, please.
Three times I saved your life. The sinkhole, your foot. What? You'd be dead if my ma hadn't taught me to dress a wound. Fine. Two times then. The sinkhole and just now.
Hey, let me see that.
Leave it. It's nothing. Hey, I'm fine.
Come on, roll up your sleeve and just admit we're friends already.
This is not an admission.
Let me see. It's getting worse.
Listen, it ain't broken or bleeding. It'll calm down. It always does. Let's go. Kit said the ward was this way. You ever hear about the North Pole?
That old fairy tale?
Yeah, like this war. Old white guy founds it, food and fresh water, everyone gets along. That sounds like the fairy tale to me. It's probably just a couple old timers holed up underground. I just hope they got a few supplies for trade. Otherwise, we won't last much longer. You think people actually live like this?
I'm not sure.
I don't know what's in that Fulton's original blend, but I never seen nobody that happy before. Not in real life.
Yeah.
Locked. Great. Ugh, we can't turn back now. Ain't got nowhere to go. There's gotta be another way through. About time. What took you? Can't let it go to waste. Use it on that bum ankle of yours. Hey, look at this. Hey, come on. Let's get some distance between us and these bodies. Oh, this is bad. This is bad with a side of broccoli.
A side of what?
Nothing. Something my mom used to say. Hey, that don't count, by the way. Starting to think looking for this ward wasn't such a good idea. Deadwood ain't all gone after all.
Nope.
Ain't no way the war's real. Not with a nest like this out here. You know, maybe best we head back. Retrace our steps. We can find another way out.
Okay, this is it.
It's not happening. Tell me this is not happening.
It's okay. You're safe. Whoa, whoa, hold up. We're friends. We're here to help.
Can't hold this forever, Bo! Moving on three. You're on your own now.
Hey, we still got each other.
Right. Follow us, you two. That won't be the last of them.
Root are thick down here.
Must be what I felt back at the ward.
Wait! You're from the ward? Shit! Maybe Santa's real too.
Yeah, it's not far from here. But the way down collapsed behind us. We're gonna have to find another way out.
Would know they've lost, but they won't lay down without a fight.
You okay?
Not bad shooting, Traveler.
Yeah, I had some practice.
I'll bet. But don't worry. The ward's as safe a place as any. Safer.
So, it's really real. Food, and water, and folks living with some old white guy?
More or less.
Whoa, whoa, let me get you some water.
I'm fine, I...
Ooh, that looks like root rot. I've never seen a case this bad.
I'm fine. I don't know why everyone...
We need to get her to the ward, and quick. Doctor, there's her only chance. We'd better get moving, or we lose the light.
Yeah.
This is Wriggler.
Call me Riggs. I got you, darling. Don't worry, friend. We'll take good care of her. Welcome to Ward 13.
Hey, don't worry. Riggs is right. She'll be fine.
Are you okay?
Just a headache.
Hey, hey, Clementine. Let me get you some water.
I'm fine.
Oh, you're not fine. You need rest.
Bo! He's the ward's mayor. Thinks that puts him in charge of everything and everyone. Listen, I'm gonna check in with Ford, and then I'll get some rest, okay? I've been through a lot worse, you know.
So, Traveler, your friend will be fine. I'm Bo Ward, and this is Ward 13. You must have come a long way. I mean, the route's dwindling and all, but the road's still a dangerous place. What were you two doing out there? For the ward? Really? Huh. I didn't know anybody knew what we were doing here. We've just, we've been cut off from the world for so long that... Well, I'm surprised people know about us outside the gate. Feels kind of nice, actually. Hey, ask around if you need something. Oh, start with Ford. I'm sure he'd like to meet you.
Audrey, I've been meaning to tell you something.
You sounded so much like Brad just now. Sorry. What did you want to say?
Oh, I saw a bird this morning. A seagull. Or something.
Oh, that's nice.
This is not up for discussion, Clementine. You're staying, and that's final.
I don't remember asking for your permission.
Watch your tone, young lady.
Excuse me? I'm 132 years old, in case you forgot. And I am not your child. You don't have authority over me.
On this, I do. This town needs you. You can't go wandering off after something that... that might not even exist.
Oh, that's rich. What have you been doing the last 100 years then, huh? What the hell are you doing right now?
Well, that's different. I'm trying to fix things.
Things that you...
We'll talk about this later.
Out of my way.
Whoa, what have we here? Ah, the traveler, of course. Wallace said yes, right on time. Sorry you had to see that. But then again, you've been around. I'm sure you know. Families fight. Andrew Ford. Good to make your acquaintance. In the flesh. Oh, I'm as real as a toothache. I'm sure you've got a lot of questions, and I've got a favor to ask. So let's get to it. You first. That's a longer story than I can indulge right now. Let's keep it to this. You know how some things you drink can make you drunk, and some things you eat can make you sick or sleepy? Well, other things do this. It's a big world out there. Not my way. And you want to be careful what you wish for, traveler. Oh, nothing too dangerous. I've got to marshal my resources. And then we'll get into it in earnest. Not you precisely, as in name, rank, serial number. But I knew someone was coming. Aren't you clever? Skeptic. That's fine. It so happens I knew you'd be coming today. Or I hoped. Our young Wallace told me. Wallace? He's a special kid. A lot like somebody I used to know. She had bad dreams, too. Dreams about things that hadn't yet come to pass. If you can find me someone who can explain it better, bring him in. Anyone in particular? Arguing's not the same as fighting. Clem and I have known each other longer than anyone else here. That's a lot of water to put under a narrow bridge. Looks can be deceiving. In fact, she's 132 years old. Not quite. Clementine spent a long time away, keeping strange company. Something like that will change you. Compared to who? Bo might be young, but he knows the run of a ward. Learned from the best. He was orphaned, just a kid. Ward 13 sort of adopted him. Ran security when he got old enough. Did a damn good job of it. Only made sense to put him in charge once we started up here. Don't think there's a soul in town has lost as much as Riggs. Don't know how that man gets up out of bed every day. Okay? All right, traveler. Now that you've shot, I need an able young scrapper to help an old man out. Talk to Wally. You'll find him out by the docks. After that, gear up, and then meet me at the ward gate. I'll tell you a story.
Your friend looks pretty bad. She's gonna die, isn't she?
I see you, traveler. You're the one Ford's been waiting for. Though, he doesn't know he's been waiting. He thinks he needs help. It's her who needs it. You know. And you don't. Sorry, I shouldn't say. Things get messier when I tell them. I'm Wallace. Did I say that yet? Probably. The site, you know? Sorry, I probably said that already too. You have a path to walk. You choose the first step here, but your path can change if you wanted to. Sense now. You're right, of course. Your path is waiting. Tell Brabus and McCabe I sent you. They have what you need. They're the next step on your journey. I'll see you again, traveler.
You are right, Mutter. Traipsing in here like you own the place. That boy what talks to the root? I don't trust Wally with a hot meal. But I also ain't dumb enough to cross him. I don't reckon he was any more specific. Right. Well, the boy's crazy, but he ain't stupid. And I can see your gear is, lacking, to say the least. If he asks, you tell him I gave you this. No charge. Riggs is gonna talk my ear off if I don't send you over to him next, isn't he? Fine. Go see Riggs, then. Tell him he can do whatever the hell he wants.
Riggs could help me out. I should stop by sometime.
I swear to God and my mother. Did Bo send you over here, or did you stumble your way over here yourself? You're serious, aren't you? All right, so what the hell is this journey? I swear, if that boy weren't so goddamn right all the time, he and I'd be having words. Percussive ones. Fine. Well, the only reason anyone bothers me is because I'm good with a hammer. So, either I can modify your weapons, or we can find a more creative use for it. Tell you what, I heard you picked up something strange on your little jaunt earlier. Maybe I could do something with it. Forever for you to make up your mind. Yeah, yeah. not gonna wait forever for you to... This bet... Did well? To help with whatever journey he saw you on. So we're done here, right? Or do I need the hammer again? Oh, it's a miracle. Look, pisses me off, so I'll make you a deal. You find anything interesting out there, bring it back to me, and I'll see if I can use it to mod your weapons. Okay? Oh, and if you tell anyone I was nice to you, I will cut you.
Oh, friend. Glad to see you're all right. What can I do for you? That's right. But everybody calls me Riggs. I try to keep folks safe out there. My specialty is armor and weapons upgrades. Speaking of which, Beau mentioned you might need some help getting your feet back on, do you? Well, whatever you need, don't be afraid to ask. We all help each other out here. Even McCabe. I don't suppose he was more particular about why. Ha, yeah, that sounds like Pravis. Right. Well, I've got a pretty focused skill set. I reckon I know what he means. Come to me if you ever need to upgrade your equipment.
Geared up and ready. Should we head out? Or, is there something you wanted to do first? Right. Let's see what dangers still lurk in the old ward. Just crank the handle to make it work. This used to be a research facility, cutting edge. We did things down here nobody dreamed of. Not before nor since. Yet, for all our manpower, we didn't know what the stones really were. Until it was too late.
The stones?
The world stones. Giant radiations that let us see into other worlds, even travel to them. So, what? We just hide the stones away and hope the Soviets haven't found their own. No. We had to know everything there was to know about it. It was a matter of national security, of pride. So yeah, we opened the door and walked through.
But something was waiting on the other side.
It didn't happen right away. Hell, the inhabitants of the world we battled couldn't follow us. We thought we were safe. But yeah, the route found a way. After that, well, we all know what happened after that. Locked, huh? Well, This is my house. Come on. I gave Ellen a few things to hang on to in case of emergency. She must have hidden it around here somewhere. Come on, Ellie, where'd you hide it? That red thing. We call it a dragon heart. Don't ask why. Take it with you. You might need it. Come on, let's go. There you are. Hurry up. Let's get this door unlocked.
Can't stand around all day.
Is that the...
The World Stone. Yes. Or part of it, anyway. Every shard's as useful as the whole. We shut it down after Harsgard died. Like I told Ellen at the time. The damn thing's more dangerous than useful. Of course not. Never mind. Now, let's see if that worked.
Work to do what exactly?
Tell Bo to bury this place. Not just lock it away, but get some explosives and bury it in a tomb of concrete. More dangerous than useful, traveler. Remember that.
Ford? Ford? Ford! Oh, man. Bo is gonna be pissed.
Did it. He actually woke it up.
Clementine? Hey.
Did he tell you how to use it? Do I even want to?
System failure is imminent. The core has been compromised. The utility is required. Commencing acquisition.
Ah! Help! Clementine! Don't let go! Somebody take me! Clementine! Shit! Oh, shit! Oh, shit. Oh, no, 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 no. Don't do it. Don't you do it. Oh, this is so stupid. No!
Clementine? Ford?
Shit. Where are you guys? This is all insane. Both the crystal and Ford. Jeez. Okay. Better get moving if I'm gonna find Clementine.
Axel. Nothing I've ever seen.
Shit! It's coming!
Go!
company!
Thank you.
to find an audience these days. The Drizir had always been cerebral, but that trend seems to worsen the longer we sail in the land. My nature yesterday, the ephemeral music was how weightless. The Drizir suffered from all things after all. Why devote precious time to a song destined to be forgotten? I had no answer for them. Their music, like all created things, is temporary. That's not the point.
Oh, I could use that.